Hello to internet. Today I want to try how it feels to ride a longer distance with this Milan SL.
And first, of course, I need to ride a long distance to be able to tell you how it feels. And to do that, I'm getting help from Tuomas. He's the guy who bought my Quest.
Mitä oot tykännyt Questista?
Mä oon tykännyt kyllä siis. Oikein mukaan.
Ei sitä enää niinkö millään
henkeä antaisi pois.
We are taking a part to this traditional cycling event around here called Arvon Kuntoajo. This year the actual ride is only 60 kilometers long, but it's fine with us because this is only the second ride for Tuomas this year and I've been commuting every day this week, so I'm already exhausted and Tuomas will be exhausted shortly. We are taking it pretty easy. I'm not sure if I'm even going to show you the ride data from Strava later on this video because it's just so lame. But anyway, we are still faster than the roadies. There is, by the way, about 40 participants in this event. But this was my first longer ride with this Milan SL, which is by the way provided by Jan and the team from velomobileworld.com. Okay, now I'm at 97 kilometers. And it's something like 15 kilometers back home. So it's going to be something like 113 kilometers or something like that. But before I'm going to tell you how it felt to ride this long ride with this Milan SL, I'm going to show you what preparations I made for this long trip.
Now we have reached the halfway point of this ride, which is here in Ullava. At this point my average speed was around 32 kilometers per hour and average power about 150 watts. So yeah, we were taking it quite easy so far. Coffee and bun from M-Market Lukkari is included in the participation fee of the event. I took this kind of bread roll and some juice. We spent around 15 to 20 minutes here before we started to head back.
Penkkihan on ihan läpimärkä. Ja mulla on kato, jo sullahan taitaa olla tuota, sulla on tuo vähän parempi.
Ei tää oo silloin ihan märkä.
Tää ei samalla se kuiva. Se vähän niinkö.
Se mitä mä jaksan
siellä rikoilla. Pikkusen ilma kiertää tuolla, kun tää on kato tämmöstä. Tämä kun kastuu.
Tuo on samantyyppistä mitä oli alueiden.
Niin on, sulla oli semmoista. Tää on tosi mukavan tuntunen, mutta sitten kun tää kastuu, niin se on
tosi märältä.
Tuntuu märältä.
Joo.
Tästä ei sinua ole huomannut. Se on niin kuin, se onnistunut tuo materiaali tässä kyllä.
Tähän reittiin me lähdetään takaisin. Mennäänkö me tuosta vai? Mennäänkö tuolta kautta?
This year the route of the event is kind of free, so you can basically choose your own route if you want. But we decided to just take the same road back. It's mostly downhill, so it will be fun. Here my top speed was around 68 kilometers per hour. The road is actually not in very good shape, so it actually doesn't feel very safe to ride this fast. Yeah, the asphalt really has seen better days.
Hey, if you want this kind of awesome t-shirts, you can find these on my webshop. The link is in the video description. First I took this Ventisit floor mats from my Quattrovelo, because you really need this kind of floor mat, because you are going to sweat so much here inside that. Look at this, there's a lot of sweat over there. And you don't want your stuff to be in that sweat puddle. Like for here example, I have one of my cameras here. It's nicely here on top of this Ventisit floor mat, and the sweat puddle is underneath. Like this. So yeah, you are going to need this kind of floor mats. Unfortunately, they don't sell these for Milan, so that's why I had to use these Quattrovelo floor mats. And these fits actually quite nicely here. Maybe a little bit too long, but that's easy to solve, but I don't want to cut these because these are from my Quattrovelo. Then one other thing I did was to mount this water bag here. This is my drinking system. About 3 liters of water here in this bag. And this kind of drinking hose where you can drink. I put a velcro here, so the hose sticks to the velcro like this. And then I made this small hole here, which keeps this bag here in place. I have this kind of hook on this bag, so I can put it like this, so it stays upright here. One problem I had with this drinking system was this hose. When the road was in very bad shape, this hose dropped a little bit like this and it went between my shoulder and the body of the velomobile. And that wasn't very nice. Then one thing I noticed about this Milan. These parts Apparently these are not stainless steel or aluminium because there's a lot of corrosion already. And that's not very cool.
And now we are already back in Calvia from where we started. Or actually where I started. Tuomas had to first ride about 30 kilometers to get here. But anyway, now we are going to Pekan Pizza to eat something.
Ja se on kevyys, että tulee tänne päin.
Mm. 88 kilometriä.
Niinkö? Mulla on vasta 63. Oli varmaan hattua, sulla oli leviämät renkaat, niin...
Ei ne montut niin paljon.
Toimii paremmin tuolla. Noin paskalla tie. Niin.
Menee vähän pehmiämmin niistä reiistä, ei tuntuu niin syvä.
Kyllä kapasilla renkailla on kyllä... Ne on aika kymmisiä kivoja ne töissä.
Mä huomasin, että sä aika paljon liikuit siinä
ajokaistalla, että piti aika...
Mutta piti hakea vähän kohtaa, että mistä vihti aina ajaa.
Niin ei oikeastaan se ole.
Kyllä tää vain menee märäksi tää.
Iu. Tuo menee.
I took a burger, which I almost forgot to show you. This is again included in the participation fee of the event. But this is basically the end of the event. And now we are supposed to go back home. Tuomas has yet another 30 kilometers back home and I decided to accompany him for a while on his way back home. So, off we go again. And then it started to rain.
Okay, the weather got a little bit bad at the end. Hey, by the way, if you like this kind of content, please click the like button below the video. That would be very helpful. Okay, so how was it to ride 100 kilometers with this Milan? Well, first of all, the seating position is very comfortable. I didn't get any numb ass and I didn't get any knee problems or my legs didn't hurt or anything like that. I think that's due to the short cranks which I have here. I have the 140 mil cranks, which are great. The only problems are with the neck rest, even though that's very comfortable. For some reason I did get some neck pain, but that's probably just my fault. I'm probably constantly trying to lift my head from the neck rest for some reason. I think that I just need to learn to sit properly or something. And the other problem is of course that I'm sweating so much that all my clothes are very wet already. And there's some sweat puddles over there, which I already showed you. But I don't know if this sweating, is this just my problem or do everyone sweat like this? I don't know. Then because it's raining, I kind of don't like to ride in rain with this Milan. First of all, I don't like the visor. I prefer the helmet type visor, which for example Quattrovelo has. It works much better in rain. It's going to get very foggy inside. My glasses are very foggy and the visor gets foggy. So I do have to keep the Naka duct open. And because that is open, a lot of rainwater will get inside. Also this service hatch is leaking. There's water dripping on my legs. Not very nice. But other than those problems, this is very comfortable to ride on this kind of longer distances. And I would definitely take this one to a long ride instead of my Quattrovelo, because this is so much more efficient and faster than the Quattrovelo. But unfortunately, this year I haven't had a lot of time for this kind of long rides. But I have done some great Velomobile trips before, like for example this one. This was a 3-day Velomobile trip with my Quest, and it was very nice trip. So maybe you should go watch this series of videos next. Thanks for watching, and see you next time. Bye bye.